Hey guys, what is up? It is me, Pagey, here once again with another video on The Flash Season 7, and more specifically, the 150th episode of The Flash. So as most of us should know, but I would hope, you know, all of us would know, this week is the first episode, or the beginning, of the Godspeed arc that will be wrapping up this season of The Flash. Now, there is a chance that this arc will continue into next season, that being Season 8, which does sound weird, but I base that off this upcoming tweet from Eric Wallace, who is the showrunner for The Flash, who does always like tweet out at the end of, and sometimes at the beginning of, a storyline for The Flash. But yeah, this is what he said. And so, interlude 1 is complete, in brackets, 7.12 to 7.14, which are the episodes, season 7, episode 12, through to season 7, episode 14. Starting Tuesday, June 29th. We're in June. Yeah, he got the date months mixed up. June 29th, graphic novel number 4 begins. Episode 7:15 to question mark. Join me, won't you? Yeah, I just felt like my brain was melting then because the date got the wrong month was there. Anyway, so the first thing to bring up from this is that he is calling that run of 3 filler episodes, that's what they were, interlude 1, which is interesting. But I think most of us would be, you know, hoping that that is the first and last interlude. But of course, the most interesting thing is that he says graphic novel number 4, or the Godspeed arc, starts this week with episode 15, but doesn't have an end episode, just a question mark. Now, of course, maybe this is just him being mysterious for the sake of being mysterious. But and then maybe like the Godspeed arc starts in episode 15 and actually ends in 18, like we expect, the finale for season 7. But maybe keep that question mark from Eric Wallace in that tweet in the back of your head. Maybe the storyline does continue into the beginning of season 8, and the end of season 7 is a big enough of like a whoa. You know, that we're sort of happy that we chill on that and then we come back to it because maybe it needs more time and it directly leads into something else in season 8. Who knows? It's just interesting you left that question mark in there, so keep that in mind. But anyway, over the past couple of days, roughly, the CW released the official description or synopsis for the 150th episode of The Flash, which is episode 17 for this season, the second last episode of the season. Of course, this episode will feature the return of characters such as Jay Garrick and XS, as well as the debut of Bart Allen slash Impulse. But yeah, this episode is called Heart of the Matter Part 1. So of course, the finale is Heart of the Matter Part 2. But yeah, let's read this synopsis out and then have a little chat about it and some other stuff containing or revolving around this, might I say. Barry and Iris greet their future children, XS and Bart, only for a shocking secret to threaten their new familial harmony. Meanwhile, the Godspeed War intensifies and threatens to destroy Central City. So the first thing I want to talk about in regards to this is that the episode is actually being written by, or co-written, might I say, by Eric Wallace. Now, usually showrunners write the first and last episode of the season and maybe another episode randomly in between, maybe like a mid-season finale. But this season was weird where we had the end of season 6 included. So Eric Wallace, I think, has only written one episode so far this season. I might be wrong, but there's only one episode I can remember him writing, which was episode 3, which served as like the finale for the season 6 story. So I'm not too sure whether he is also writing the next episode after this, which is of course the season 7 finale. That information is not out there as of yet. I'm sure we'll find out fairly soon, but at this moment we don't know. So he might not be writing the finale, or he's writing, or taking part in the writing of 2 episodes in a row, which maybe he had time to do. I mean, if it's a 2-part story, maybe he co-wrote, like wrote the outline or something like that, and then someone's filling in the bricks or filling in the pieces. We'll have to wait and see, but I'm sure, as I said, we'll find out soon. Now, in regards to the synopsis as a whole, obviously we knew that XS, Impulse, Jay Garrick coming into this episode. As I said before, we knew that going into this synopsis and everything like that, that was revealed a while ago. But of course, there are some, you know, interesting things getting revealed here. So, like, what is this threat to their familial harmony? So, obviously, this would be, this is a shocking secret's going to come out. I guess it depends on who reveals it. It's going to have to be, I guess, either Barry and Iris or XS and Bart. You'd have to assume that's what it is. One thing that a lot of people have been theorizing is maybe that it's learned to both Nora and Bart, or XS and Impulse, that Nora had died, you know, pre-crisis, because Barry and Iris would remember that moment. So, maybe, or at least Barry would specifically remember that moment. So maybe that's discovered or something along those lines. Maybe that's blurted out or something along those lines. another possibility is that it has something to do with their family lineage. Now, one big change with Impulse heading into this season is that he is now the son of Baron Iris, when in the comics, he is the grandson. Now, a lot of people go, oh, that doesn't matter. Like, who cares? The big reason it's a change, and it was actually, the reason it's a big change for the show and would change how they actually flesh out any sort of story with Bart, is that he's actually, even though he's the grandson of Baron Iris, he's also a Thorn, as in Eobard Thorn. Melanie Thorn is his mother. I think Eobard Thorn is, she's a descendant of Eobard Thorn. So Bart is a descendant of not only Barry Allen, but also Eobard Thorn. So that's what makes that character fairly interesting. And when you make him the son of Baron Iris, it sort of rips that away. However, maybe there's a secret involving Thorn here, and maybe he's involved with this in some way, shape, or form, and that's revealed. I mean, that'd be a shocking secret that would threaten their new, you know, the new harmony between their family, wouldn't it? I mean, I could see that happening. I don't think they're going to go down that route, but it would be somewhat accurate to the comics, outside of the fact that he's now the son instead of the grandson, but yeah. One other thing to keep in mind going into this episode that could play a part in this shocking secret, or just anything to do with this reunion, I guess, and what's happening in present day, is that Barry should be alive in their future. Remember, he died, he wasn't alive in the future because of crisis and stuff like that, but he should be alive now. So will we see an older Barry? I think that'd be fairly cool. I mean, we've seen older Iris, we've seen older Oliver Queen. We've seen like all these older versions of characters, even in that, season 3 or whatever it was, we saw like the older versions of characters in that timeline, like Julian Abbott, Killer Frost, Joe, Sherlock, Cisco. We saw older versions of that. We have yet to see a proper older version of Barry. So could this be the episode that we see him? If we don't, I would at least like to hear them reference him and maybe talk about him in some capacity about certain things. Like, will we learn when he stopped being the Flash? When he, you know, hung up the boots and hung up the suit, if you want to call it. And we can assume that Impulse and Excess took over for him in that role. I wouldn't mind learning that. I think that'd be fairly cool. I think that'd be something that we would like to hear, because it just fleshes out the world that we might not see. So I think that'd be fairly cool. Now, this is something that a lot of people were picking up on from the synopsis, and that's that the synopsis doesn't say Nora and Bart, as in like Nora West Allen and Bart Allen. They say Excess and Bart. So is Nora no longer Excess? We know that Jessica Parker Kennedy is playing her, but is Nora no longer her name? Is she Dawn West Allen now or something like that? Or this is what I think. Are they calling her Excess rather than Nora in the synopsis in order not to confuse people with Nora Allen, as in Barry's mother, who has already appeared this season? From memory, in press releases in regards to this 150th episode of The Flash, she had been referred to as Nora West Allen alongside Excess, but maybe that was just based off previous episodes, and maybe she does have a new identity when she comes back here. I mean, it would be weird if Barry and Iris decided to change her name, because it's not like Barry and Iris would all of a sudden be like, yeah, nah, we're over the name of Nora. That was an impulsive decision. I mean, she's named after Barry's mother, so why wouldn't they call her that? But maybe they're like, oh, let's just call her something else. I mean, you have to think they would stick with the name of Nora, but like we always say, we'll have to wait and see. I'm sure we'll find out soon enough, when some other information around the episode comes out, like what her actual name is. But maybe the reason they're not calling her Nora there is because they've already had a Nora this season, so it's just easier to call her Excess, but we'll have to wait and see. Now, obviously, they did talk about the Godspeed War. This comes up again. So the Godspeed War isn't just for, is it episode 16? I think they referenced that. The Godspeed War is just like this war that takes place in one episode. It's still happening as we head into the last couple of episodes of the season. So one question I have is whether the Godspeed War takes place over multiple time periods, or it's just in the present day. It's just in 2020/2021, depending on wherever they are in the Arrowverse timeline. Because there are set photos showing Godspeed attacking Impulse, but that could easily be in present day after Bart first shows up in the present day, because Barry and Excess, we'll say, show up there as well in those set photos. So I'm intrigued, because we still don't know necessarily the motives of Godspeed, and I guess have Excess and Impulse, like these versions at least, taken on Godspeed before, because we don't necessarily know if they're changing origins in regards to whether he is actually from the future or originates from the present day now. It'll be interesting, but I am interested to see if this Godspeed War has been going for a while in the future, and now it's deciding to come back and take place in the present day. So technically, it's taking place over multiple time periods. I mean, that'd be fairly cool, but it could be a bit of a mess at the same time. Now, the last thing to talk about is actually Impulse and Excess and their futures, and that's continuing into next season. Because it was reported by people in Vancouver that they've asked around that those characters are meant to continue into next season. So is that why Eric Wallace put a question mark in that tweet? Because stuff revolving around the storyline doesn't end at the end of this season. It continues into the beginning half of next season as well. So maybe those opening five episodes of next season, which we know serve as like mini crossovers with other heroes, play off what happens at the end of this season of The Flash. Obviously, Godspeed is a question mark about continuing over into next season. There are some set photos out there that sort of maybe answer that question, but at the same time, set photos don't give away everything. They just sort of tease you for certain things. Or maybe it's something like the multiverse opening up again, which leads into those mini crossover episodes happening at the beginning of next season and other heroes potentially being able to show up. Obviously, a lot of them already exist on Earth Prime, but some don't. So maybe that's what happens. I'm curious. I think this will be a very interesting end to the season. I think it'll be a very action-packed end. But I'm just wondering how it finishes off leading into next season as well. I'm curious. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, it'd be awesome if you could drop a like on it to show your support. Let me know in the comment section down below your various opinions on all of this, what you're looking forward to most in this final few episodes of the season, but also, I guess, specifically the 150th episode. Is it just seeing the Flash family together, you know, Bart, Nora, Barry, Jay Garrick back? You looking forward to that? If only Wally was there. If Wally was there, we'd have all of them. But anyway, that can't happen, I guess, because of damn COVID. But yeah, let me know your opinions down there in the comments. And of course, if you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe. And I will catch you guys later. Goodbye.